know, today I get the opportunity to welcome you all officially as college students. And I want you to think, just for a second. Close your eyes. I'm going to say something. I want you to think about it. Close your eyes. I want you to envision yourself when you were a freshman in high school. And it should bring a smile to your face. What were you wearing? And then when I moved later, my family moved to a different city, about a third of my classmates were Hispanic, a third were African American, and a third were Caucasian. And that's when I actually saw and understood what diversity was. Because where I grew up, and it may be the same for some of you, everybody looked like me, everybody talked about me, everybody had the same problems and experiences. Here in this room, I guarantee you, there's somebody in this room who has nothing in common with you. And you can ask somebody for that. This is a kind of funny piece of advice that comes from like a smart perspective, but I want you to just grab it now and carry it with you. It sounds crazy, but go to class prepared. That may sound crazy. That may sound like a radical idea. Go to class prepared. I want you to think about it like this. If you were to read your playbook for sports, if you were to learn your lines for a play on the stage, if you were to learn music or an instrument or a song, and your coach or your director gave you that music and said, "We'll see you tomorrow," would you look at it before tomorrow? The answer is yes, I would. Your professors are head coaches. Do what they say. It's so amazing. I have a 15-year-old son. He came to me the other day. He's trying out for the wrestling team. I'll talk a little bit about wrestling here in a minute. And he said, "You know, coach said," and he goes on to say these things. And I'm thinking, I told you that like 10 times. Who the heck is this coach guy? And why does he get that? in your life.